Hello, everyone, and welcome to another episode of my Time Capsule series for The Long Dark. Today, we're going to be doing yet another new version called version 0.393, Resolute Outfitter. And this is the version that Forlorn Muskeg comes out in. So we had Mystery Lake, then we had Coastal Highway, then we had Pleasant Valley, then we had Desolation Point, then we had Timberwolf Mountain, and now we're having Forlorn Muskeg. So those are the orders that the regions came out in. I wanted to do some of the in-between versions to introduce some of the new mechanics and new things that came into the game. But again, because of the short time frame I have, I'm going to just do the ones where the regions come out. And I'll explain some of the things that they came out with, because I did a little test run with this already. And I'll show you some of the changes, and I'll explain that as I go. So without further ado, let's get started. Okay, here we are, ladies and gentlemen. So this is the main screen for this version. Obviously, it's of Trappers again. But, you know, the funny thing is when I'm looking at this, I see this shovel here. You know, I think I saw it on the last one. It's really, you know, we don't use a shovel in the game. But it's funny how it's like there. It's just there like it's some kind of prominent thing. You know, like this is prominent. I mean, this is in the game. Backpacks and rifle. But it's really funny seeing this. And so anyway, let's get started. We're going to do, like as usual, we're going to do Voyager, because this is the first version that came out with Interloper. I'll show you. So Interloper has now arrived. Okay. This is the first version it actually came out like a version before, but this is the first one with new region. So, but Interloper came out like just slightly before this one, like one or two updates before this one, but they were mostly just additional updates with modes and challenges. And also what was added was all the challenges were added. So we got Hopeless Rescue, Hunted Part 1. Of course, that'll unlock when you do Part 1. Whiteout and Nomad. So these are all here for your enjoyment if you want to try the early version of the challenges. And so nothing else new besides that, except that now they have the journal. Or they didn't really have the journal. And also notes were added to the game. So now you can add notes and add journals and things like that. Also, they introduced a new mechanic with sticks called brands. And they took the place of all the flares you used to have to use for the wolves. They're supposed to help with, I guess, wolf deterrence and start fires with. But the problem is you can't, once you pull a brand, you can't put it out and put it in your inventory. You have to just carry it. And it doesn't last nearly as long as a flare or a torch. So what they did was they left the ability to craft torches, so you can craft torches, but if you want to pull something out of a fire, in the early version, before I played this, you were able to pull torches. Well, they took that out and used brands, and from what I remember from talking to people, veterans of this game, who have been playing longer than I have mentioned that there is a big stink about when they introduced brands, because I'd already played an Interloper version of this already. I already played this one, and I'm like, can't control the wolves with these brands. They kind of ignore them. They really don't do much, and I got attacked and killed a couple of times. So it's really strange with the brands. I'll show you as we play. But anyway, let's get started. I'll explain things that happen, the additions as we play. So again, we're gonna do Voyager, because I want to be able to walk around and talk, and you know, I mean, we'll still have dangerous for wolves, but it won't be so bad, you know, it's just a little bit lighter. All right, and let's confirm. And where are we going to start? Choose random, like, but I don't want to spawn here yet. I want to spawn somewhere else and enter here. Okay. So I'm thinking that let's just have a start with at Mystery Lake. We'll go into Forlorn Muskeg from there. So I think that we'll just have Mystery Lake start. Sound good? All right, let's do it. Play Astrid. Played well last time. So this we're gonna do. We're gonna call this FM. Okay. Except now you notice they changed the fonts and of the game, and some of the graphics are much nicer than. It's obvious they're improving the map building and all that. So, where will we spawn? That's the question. Well, it's at night, for one. Right on the tracks. Right by the farm, right by camp office, right where a wolf probably be. But that is how you get to Muskeg. That I know because I know the game so well. But that's how you get there, obviously. But we're going to, what time is it? It's early in the morning. So you notice they changed the HUD around. There's only 1 hour darkness left. That's pretty good. Maybe what we'll do is we'll go into the camp office and sleep for an hour. Just get the daylight. And then we've got to get sticks. Might have to build a fire, get some water going, you know, things like that. I think the mouse sensitivity again is a little bit too rough. A lot of things that I did a store, I've done this before, but just a little bit. That's better. Okay, for some reason it wasn't that bad, but when I started recording now it seems to be a lot, but okay. I think we'll crash here for an hour or so. What a beautiful. Yeah, see, it looks to me like. So they fixed the trees. The graphics certainly look better in the trees. And the sky certainly looks a lot better, too. The moon is a little bit better. It's better all around. And it looks to the rocks, too. The rocks are different. They added shadows and more snow on the ledges of the rocks to make it more realistic. That's really good. They did a good job so far. I really like the progression. All right. I believe that we have a bedroll. When we're Voyager, we probably have a bedroll. I would think. Yeah. One thing I noticed is in the early versions, placing a bedroll is so much easier than it is now. It could almost go anywhere. Now it's just, it's got to put it in specific places, and it's a pain. It really is. Let's just do, let's do 2 hours just to get through. I'm not tired enough. How about we just pass time? There we go. Like I said, I'm not going to try to loot too much because it's going to be more of an adventure than a long-term survival, I said, but we're going to get the essentials, sure.
This stuff will come in handy.
Yeah, it might. Astrid speaks. When Astrid speaks, we listen, right? Soda. We'll check that area in a minute. I just want to check upstairs there. Hey, what's up, bud? You know, some people name this corpse. I have all the time, long time I played and the hours in this game, I've never actually done that. I always say, hey, buddy, what's up? Oh, running shoes. So I think this is also the first version that these running shoes were incorporated in the game, I think. Because I don't remember seeing them. Or just another bedroll.
I think I can use this.
I don't know, can you? Oh, and by the way, the clothing screen has now changed. You actually have it like now you're more used to it now, where it has a double layer inner and outer now. So they added that in the game. So they changed a lot of the graphics here, right? And it gave you the stats now here where they didn't do that before. I mean, at least not like this anyway. So that being said, what did I pick up? And I got. So I picked up another pair of jeans. And oh, and I picked up. So they still have, you gotta break these down if you want them, but they still have, you cook at the fire, you don't place them on the fire anymore, like you do now. Still haven't incorporated that. I don't know. Could end up being useful. We'll need that in case we start a fire. No curtains on the windows here yet. They will put them eventually. Because they're there now. Coffee, yes. I love coffee in the game and in real life. Magnets, nice. We'll just get a bunch of stuff now and then. Ooh, lanterns. See, I can now make fuel, torches. Before I couldn't find the fuels, what we'll do is. Well, that was weird information. Let's fill that up. Oh, it's already full. Oh, not really. Almost full. Okay. I want to make torches, but before I do that, I need to get cloth. Sticks. So, why don't we take a walk up to the tower here? Check that out. You can pick up sticks on the way, and can't get cloth away, but might be a piece of. Look at that sign. It's an old sign. I wonder when they put that new sign in. I wonder when they do that. Yeah, so what we'll do is we'll loot the main areas here. We're not going to bother with the dam. It's just too much. We'll just get what we can in the places here. We'll end up at Trapper's and because we're going to go to Muskeg from Trapper's. Let's just get some of the main areas here. We'll go down there eventually too. Maybe. I don't know if they introduced my trailer down there yet. My favorite trailer in Mr. Blake is down by the dam there. It's not there in these versions yet, but I'm curious when they add it. Astrid's cold. That's all right, Astrid. You'll be fine. And I'm used to auto walk sometimes. I haven't. Auto walk doesn't come for quite a while yet, but. So this one is called Resolute Outfitter, and a lot of it has to do with, like, added a lot of with clothing crafting. They improved the clothing crafting and all that in this version, apparently. So that's kind of what they are talking about. Now, the tower isn't up here anymore, yet. It's still down that other end. So I'll tell you what, let's go down the track then. I don't have any weapons. I do have one flare. See if we get something down in the tank. I keep forgetting that tower is not there yet. They moved it from over there and put it up here, and they put the abandoned one or the broken one on the hill there. That's what they did. Not yet, though. Much later in the game. This is still the old lake map. Now, I wonder if the bunkers, the caches might be up there. I wonder if it is. I'm just going to check it. We're going to be cold. I'm not going to worry about it too much. I mean, we still have 100% condition. Over here, you know what? You can check the bunker, the old bunker places, see if they're spawned yet. See if they're in the game. They didn't mention anything about it. But now I'm curious. I do know where most of the locations, the old locations, used to be, because I did a bunker series, Prepper Cache series. If you look in my channel, you'll see I did a whole thing on all 18 of the caches. I found all of them and I've made a big series on it if you want to know where they are. But it's up this way.
Oh, it's goddamn crazy.
Oh, Ash, take it easy. You'll be fine. You see, it's up there. You got to go up there and then, like, it's up there. In the video, I showed how to get there. Like, you go up to this ridge, this peak, and then you turn left. If it's there, you'd see it almost right away. But it would be over here. It's not here, but if the prepper cache was here, it would be right in this area. It would be right here. But it's not. It would be right here. No, it's not here. Alright. Let's continue our journey where we're gonna where we were going before. It's cold, but I think we'll be alright. 96%. We'll play with our condition a little bit here. Normally, as an interloper and higher player, I would never gamble my condition that. Sometimes I do. It depends on the situation. But I try not to gamble my condition. But I can make exceptions with this. Because if we die, we'll just start another one. Is the sound loud enough? It doesn't seem like the game sounds loud enough going to the video. I want you guys to hear the game a little bit. Okay. It's possible to run into wolves down here. It's very possible. But I think we still have the grace period. There's a grace period in Voyager for predators. You get some time before they arrive. You'll hear them when they come, but I think we'll loot as much as we can until they come, which is probably why I won't need a flare right now either. There's no wolves out yet. I just realized that. So we'll take that advantage and we will loot. Oh. Oh, that's weird. That log is weird. Get, let me go. Let me go up there. Thank you. Ooh, all right, so this is when they introduced the Canadian leaf toque. And we will be putting that on right away. Put that up. Okay, so that means that the dam is actually free. There wouldn't be any wolves in the dam. That's right. Well, maybe it is, actually. So you can't pick up stones anymore. They're not introduced to the game yet. Flares are good though. We're not gonna bother with feathers.
I'll take it.
Yeah, I'll take those for sure. Oh, there we go. I was like, wait, something's not right. Let's drop those. I honestly don't know if I feel like looting the dam. It's just so much. I might just go down there and see if any of it has changed. But you can tell, like, if you've been watching this series, how much progression have happened with the graphics in the game, and how much smoother and nicer it looks. The cache could also be up there. We're going to check, because that's the other spawn point place for the cat. There's another one up the rope over there I should check out, too. But it's up here. So you can't pick up these stones. They're there, but you can't pick them up yet. I think eventually they do add it, but... Now, you could sprain yourself going up here, but this is another cache, a bunker location right up here. Actually, it's right up here. I turned right too soon. It's right up here. Right here. But it's not here. It didn't spawn. I do want to go down and check the dam area. We are losing condition here. We might have to start a fire, I think. Very soon. You know, maybe we'll make a fire at that deer over here and we'll get some meat off of it. I don't know if we have how much fuel we have, but I seem the weather is a little bit gray, isn't it? Let's cook some of this meat. I think we have enough fuel to make us a long enough fire for the deer, I think. Let me just check real quick. Yeah, I have cedar and some reclaim. I don't really have any tinder, though. I didn't make any. Tell you what, let's take a minute to make some quick tinder here. I hate doing this here, but because it gets you really cold. All right, so let's put a fire right here. And accelerant. There we go. Let's do it.
Perfect.
Let's put that in. Let's put the claim in. And a few sticks. That should warm us up, I think. Yeah, we're warm. Alright, let's gotta let it thaw a little bit. It's okay though. We'll cook water while we're here. We'll just do 1 liter at the moment. Okay, we have some water. Let's actually eat that. get some calories in us. There we go. There we go. Is that 50%? It needs to be. Almost there. Let's put a few more sticks in, get some more heat going. Let's put a little bit more water on. Let's just do a half liter for now. Normally I would micro harvest this, but we're just gonna get the whole thing. We have no tools. 55 minutes. Let's do it. Oh, you can't do it that way, huh? Gotta cook one piece at a time, huh? Okay. That makes you very stinky, doesn't it? Well, we are fully warm now. So watch what happens. So you can only take a brand, right? But you can't put it out. It drops it, right? And this is brandish, and it doesn't really work on the wolves. It doesn't. And all you can pick is one. You can only pull one. You can't put it away. It drops it. See? I'm not really crazy about that mechanic at all. But, and they don't last. Watch, it'll burn out before we probably get down here. Actually, let's eat while we goes. Nice. I don't think stink meters were introduced to the game yet, so we don't have to worry about being stink yet. I just want to go down here to see how much has changed, if anything. I'm not going to bother going in the dam, to be honest, because I just don't want to go through all that looting. So we're going to just loot. I want to see if my trailer's here, and I don't think it is yet. Yeah, they didn't add them yet. But there's a group, two trailers here in the new version, in the current version, that I always make bases out of. They're the best. Let's just go. Let's go down that way. We'll check out the logging camp and then trappers, and then we'll head out to the Muskeg. Check that base out. I am so excited for Monday for the new update. I am so excited. And I have off for work that day too. So I'm going to be, everybody know what I'm going to do. See, there's the brands burning out. See that? And that's it. Can't, now you're defenseless again. I don't think I need to worry. Like I said, I still have that grace period, so I'm all right. But that's why I want to try to explore as much as I can, because I have this grace period. Train loading area. So there's also a place for a cache up there, but I don't know if I'm gonna go up there. up. You see that rock that's back there? Right, that one right there in the middle of my screen. Right there, that's where it's at. Let's just take a quick walk. Hey, why not? We're here to explore, right? We're here to explore. Let's see if the bunker's there. I'm curious because I don't know when the bunkers were introduced in the game. Besides, we'll get sticks on the way then. There is birch bark. So just on the other side of this rock right here is the place it could be. It would be right here. It would be right here. It's not here. If it spawned, it would be right here, but it didn't. So. Okay, maybe they haven't been added to the game yet, I don't know, but I know that the Timberwolf Mountain one is there. All right, let's head into the logging camp. We'll loop that with those trailers, and then we'll head out to Trappers. Might even go up to the tower, maybe. Might, by that time, might be time to sleep there. I like the way they made the snow blowing in the air, like blowing off the surface of the ground. That's really cool. Did a good job with that. See it? I really like that. It gets you the sense of like, brr, I'm cold too, playing the game, you know? Astrid's yawning already. What are you yawning for, Astrid? We got a long way to go yet. I love the work boots. Hmm. Okay. Ooh, lucky day. I do like the work boots, so let's put those on, actually. I think they're the best in the game. Well, not really the best in the game, but they need to be repaired, though. They're pretty bad. So, let's hold on to them for now. Let's drop. Actually, let's warm up a bit. Let's take a minute to harvest it. I don't think I have any cloth. Yeah, I need to get cloth. There's none of the trailers, nothing has cloth that I can get yet. I mean, unless I find some. Ooh, a Mackinac jacket? Yes, I'll take that. Thank you very much. Of course, it needs repair big time, but... Here's some more lantern fuel. I'm wondering if I should try to find some cloth before I would like to guess I would like to make some torches. That maybe there's some up in the tower. I don't know. I don't think there is, but might be a little bit.
This stuff will come in handy.
Ooh, climbing socks. This it will. Ooh. Again, until I get some cloth, not much I can do about fixing any of them. Alright. Let's take a walk up to the tower, I guess. So I do want to kind of keep moving since I, like I said, I still have this grace period. So this is a good idea to keep moving at this point. But I really would like to get, now I'd really like to get some cloth somewhere. None of the places are giving me any. And I think that if I repair anything, I'd probably be repairing that Mackinac. It's weird how, look at that deer standing on the side of the bank like that. It's so weird, like at an angle. You don't know where to go. Where to go. So we're gonna go ahead up that tower. It's a long walk, but might crash there. I hope I can find a piece or two of cloth up there. It'd be great. I don't know if there is, though, to be honest. Bear cut. I don't like hunting this bear. There's really no place for you to hide, to stand on or whatever. He can get you in most places. You could kind of stand on top of the log pile. That does help. Got any cloth? No cloth. Oh, Astrid, you're fine. You got this, love. We're almost there. We got one more little loop around. One more S turn, I think. It's definitely windy.
So cold.
It's right up there, Ash. But here, let's run a little bit. Good job, Ash. Good. So, in the, obviously in the new version, they had moved this tower to over by the camp office, moved that broken one, which is not, doesn't exist yet, over there. And I don't think you could see it yet. You used to be able to see it from this, from here. So, we do have a knife now. We can actually tear apart some pillows for cloth.
Oh, I would do anything for a drink right now.
There's nothing to tear up here. I can't tear up any cloth or anything. So, with that being said, I mean, I could tear this part, I don't think. I need a hatchet. Okay. We're going to... 2 hours of daylight left. Let's, I'm almost tempted now to go back to the hunting, back to the logging camp. Get those pillows and blankets, those old bedrolls. I can break those up. Long walk back though, backtrack a bit, you know. I'm just trying to think that there's no place, there's nothing like that in Muskeg. And I would like to go in there with better clothing. So let's maybe we will do that. We're still very cold though. All right, let's go back. And try to get because I also want to craft torches, so I'm thinking that we should go back. I'll go, harvest those pillows and bedrolls. I'll sleep. And then I'll go to the camp office and craft torches. Because now we have lantern fuel. We have, we're about to get cloth, and we'll have sticks. And we'll recover our condition while we do it, too. We have plenty of food, I think, for now, right? Yeah.
Oh, I could just lay down and have a little sleep right here.
Yeah, I know, Astrid. I know you could, but we're not. So yeah, we'll go back and we'll harvest those blankets and stuff. And then we can make torches. We'll go to back to the camp office, or we'll go to trappers. I think we need a workbench to make torches, I believe. So we'll get as much cloth as we can. We'll get some sleep. We'll recover our condition. We'll head over to the camp office and craft them, I suppose. And then maybe we'll skip trappers and we'll just go right out to Muskeg after we fix our clothing. Fix clothing, make torches, then Muskeg. That's what we'll do. We'll just skip trappers. We don't need to go there. I mean, we have good clothing now. We just need to repair them. That Mackinaw is going to be nice. I think it's 2.0 when it's repaired. When we wake up in the morning, we might not be wolf-free. So we'll have to be careful of that. I was gonna say, where is that deer running to? I don't know which one had the most in it. I think all of them had some in it. Right? Let's just start with this one. I think this one had some blankets in it, right? Nah. Yeah. The bedroll and a pillow. That'll give us some good cloth. This gives us 2 cloth. That gives us 6. Give me 7 minutes. I wonder if I should sleep first. Because it's going to kill my condition. Let's sleep. Few hours. Now, I don't know if I could break it down in the dark. Why not let? Yeah. Okay. So we'll have to wait till morning to do it. So let's go ahead. Drink. And we'll sleep 8 hours. And we're in the back 100% condition. Let's go ahead and harvest those. Harvest that. And now we will eat, drink some soda. There we go. Alright, now we repair. Let's repair that Mac. There we go. What is it now? 62%. Let's do another one. It takes 2 cloth to repair it. That's, oh no. We're gonna have to go into another trailer and get more cloth. But we're now at 97%. All right, let's go into another trailer and get more cloth. To 27 minutes. What else can repair those? Uh-oh. Weather rolling in. Prepare that. Okay, much better shape now. Let's go. Now, wait. How much cloth does it take to craft the forge? Yeah, I can't do it. Can't look at it with the without a bench, huh? I'm wondering if I should get another couple more pieces of cloth. Let's try this trailer right here. I want to make some torches. I seriously do. I don't know how much cloth it takes. Get that. Okay. I think it's probably just 1 cloth. I want to make a good amount of torches. There will be 100%. I don't think the wolves are, might not be out quite yet. 1 hour of daylight. We really should get some wood. We're gonna have to cook water. I don't know if I can get up this way. Maybe I can. This should take me out by the creek, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, this takes me out by the creek. Oh, crap, really? Okay, I think we got by that one, I think. Yeah, so now the wolves are out, so. Life's in danger now. I'll feel much better once we have torches. I think the torches work better on the wolves than these stupid brands do. Now we're about ready to end the episode. I think what we'll do is we'll make our torches, we'll end the episode. And then next episode, we'll go into the muskeg. Check that place out. The early Forlorn Muskeg, what it was like. We might need to cook water before we do anything, though, to be honest. Yeah, we're gonna have to cook water before we sleep at night. We might even have to wait till daylight comes to craft horses. We might have to go ahead and cook water and then get to sleep and do it in the morning before we leave. Usually a few sticks over here. Let's go grab them. All right, we have enough to cook water and stuff now, I think. And now we also have lantern to see with, but it's bright enough in here I can see. Okay. Cinder plug, cedar, accelerant, go. Throw that, throw the reclaimed in there. And let's get water going.
Sounded surrounded by snow and nothing to drink.
Yes, you do, Ashley. We're going to give you this. That'll hold you over a little bit. Okay? There you go. Now you should have some water, Ash. There you go. Drink, drink. Feel better? Nice. Still got an hour and 45 minutes. We should do another one. Let's just do a liter. And... okay. So we have to eat again. Just that. Just cattails and the muskeg we'll get. Probably eat that in the morning. That gives us a good amount. We'll eat that. And we'll top off the water. And let's get a good night's sleep. And we'll call the episode there. Next episode, we venture off into the unknown. It will be the unknown for then, obviously, because it's a new region. So that's very exciting. So, again, so they added this brands thing, and I'll be honest with you, I don't like it at all. I'm not a fan. It'd be nice if you can drop it and light another one, like you can with torches, but can't do it. So, I want to craft torches so I have them for the wolves. I mean, they don't work that great either, but certainly better than brands. They don't work at all. Matter of fact, the two times I tried the brands, I got attacked, killed. So, yeah. Anyway, with that being said, thanks for coming in. We will be doing another episode very soon. Hopefully, I'll have it uploaded in the next 24 hours or so, the second part of this. Thank you again for sticking around, and I'm glad you got some really wonderful comments in the comment section about the series, and we're excited to keep going. Thank you again, and we'll talk to you later. Don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe. And thank you very much. See you later.